Hello, hello, good evening, good evening. Hello, how are you? Thank you for being on time.
Good evening, miss.
Thank you, Jancy. Good evening, Patricia. Thank you for your camera. Marlene, Andrea, Ludivina, por ahí viene Ludivina. Thank you. Rosalidia, nice. Grecia, Luis, Enriquez, Leslie, Marcela, welcome to the class. María Verónica, nice. Andrea, Berenice. Sonia, welcome, Sonia.
Good night.
Nice. Good evening, welcome, welcome. Nice, so we are about to start. It's just a moment, we are 16 right now in the class. In a few more minutes, we are going to star. Okay, so espero que hayan enviado el documento que faltaba, los que no lo habían enviado, para que ya pues se pudiera salir de ese requisito, right? Nice. Let's see. Mónica Esther, welcome, Mónica. Then vamos a esperar. Habemos 17 right now.
Good morning.
Hello, hello, good evening. Thank you for joining. Right now we are 19. Vamos a empezar con la attendance. Okay, let me open the file right here for the attendance. Here it is. Okay, so today is Tuesday, okay, Tuesday. 25th, okay, 25th. So, nice. Let's see, Alison Michelle? No? Andrea Berenice?
Present.
Thank you. Delber Alcides?
Yo, Franklin, estoy presente, pero ahorita voy en camino para casa.
Ok, Franklin, thank you. Delber no está aún, creo que no ha ingresado. Franklin, un smell ahí está. Kimberly, Elizabeth, Kimberly no la he visto. Ah, ok, you are there. Thank you, Kimberly. Crisia Maricel.
Presente.
Thank you. Leslie Marcela.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Lourdes Michel. Lourdes Michel, no. Ludivina Mendoza, por ahí está Ludivina.
Present.
Thank you, Luis de Jesús. Luis de Jesús, no. A Luis Enríquez.
Present.
Por ahí lo vi. Thank you.
Present.
María de Los Ángeles. María de Los Ángeles. No. María Verónica.
Present teacher.
Thank you, María Verónica. Then we have Marina Celeste. Thank you. Marlene Dinora.
Por ahí. Present.
Nice. Then we have Marta Stephanie. Marta Stephanie. No. Miguel Ángel.
Hey, coach.
Thank you. Mónica Esther.
Present.
Thank you, Monica. Norman Bernie. Bernie. No se ha conectado aún. Patricia Elizabeth.
Present.
Thank you, Patricia. Patricia Verónica. No. Rebeca. Sarai.
Present.
Thank you. Roberto Amilcar. Amilcar, no. Rodrigo Vidal.
Present teacher.
Thank you, Rodri. Rosa Lidia.
Present.
Thank you. Samuel Alejandro. Samuel. Alejandro, no. Sandra Lisette.
Present teacher.
Thank you. Sonia Arely.
Present.
Thank you. Valeria Esther.
Present.
Thank you. Jancy Yvette.
Present.
Thank you. Okay. So, do I mention all of you? Alguien que no haya mencionado que... Tal vez ingresó después.
María de los Ángeles.
María de los Ángeles. Ok, María, por aquí la tengo. María de los Ángeles Franco. Ahí está su asistencia. ¿Alguien más?
Bernie.
You are there. Thank you, Bernie. Now you are here. Thank you. ¿Alguien más? Ok. Let's start. Okay, so hopefully you enjoy your Tuesday. I hope so. Para los que trabajan todo el día, espero pues que sí hayan trabajado, aprovechado el día, no se hayan mojado. Por lo menos creo que en gran parte de San Salvador sí que ha llovido. Por acá yo vivo por el lado de Quetzaltepeque, también ha estado y está todavía un poco lloviendo. Así que be careful, okay? Be careful. It's better to stay at home. So, let's start. Let me share the screen. Alisten ahí sus homeworks que ya tienen, ¿verdad? Con el furniture, las oraciones que íbamos a... a completar. That's what we are going to start right now. So let me share the screen right here and we are going to continue with the presentation that we have right here. Vamos a ver. Okay, so when like this part. Okay, so let's see. Nos quedamos por aquí. There is and there are. ¿Se acuerdan que lo vimos? Pero vamos a hacer esto que tenemos pendiente. Ok, so the, this is furniture, but we have this. Ok, so hopefully you were able to, let's see. Okay, here is better to see your faces. Nice. So let's see. This is a small conversation between Linda and Chris, right? So let's see. Jancy, you will be Linda. Ok, so usted va a ser Linda y va a ir mencionando ahí las palabras que usted ha completado, right? So Luis Enríquez, so you will be Chris, ok? So,
okay.
You will be Chris. So let's see, start. Linda, in this case, is you.
Yes. Nancy. Do you live in an apartment?
No, I don't. I live in a house.
Does it have a yard?
Yes, it does.
That sounds nice. Do you live alone?
No, I don't. I live with my family.
Do you have any brothers or sisters?
Yes, I do. I have 4 sisters.
That's a big family. Do you have a big house?
Yes, we do. It has 10 rooms.
10 rooms? Does it have many bedrooms?
Yes, it does. It has 4.
Do you have your own bedroom?
Yes, I do. I'm really lucky.
Okay, nice, perfect, okay, amazing, nice pronunciation and everything was correct, okay, espero que todos lo hayan, si alguien no lo había hecho, que lo hayan completado, ahí está correcto, okay, I don't know if we have a question o alguna parte ahí que usted diga, ahí no estoy segura, yo puse esto y no escuché bien, so we can double check. ¿Todo bien?
In the second, Linda, can we use the verb to be? Because is it a yard?
Yes. Nice observation, Franklin. And the answer is yes. Sí se puede preguntar eso con el verbo to be, right? But remember that we are using do or does. Because we are talking about simple present, right? Es el que estamos practicando ahorita. Pero sí se podría usar el verbo to be. Pero en este ejercicio específico estamos practicando el do y el does. ¿Ok? Por eso es que le pusimos ahí el does. ¿Ok? Because that's what we are practicing right now, the simple present, right? But thank you, Franklin. Nice. ¿Questions? ¿Estamos bien? No nos vamos a detener mucho acá porque esto fue la tarea, ¿ok? Like Enrique, I'm sorry, Luis Enriquez and Jancy, they did it nice, so hopefully you have your conversation as well, ¿ok? Si alguien no la hizo, espero que hayan agarrado ahí la copia rapidito y completarla, ¿ok? This is part of your job. Nice, furniture. ¿Ok? Let's start with this conversation. Let's see. Be ready because I don't know who will be the participant. Okay, so let's see. I'm going to start. Okay, I'm going to start the question with some of you, and then the other person is going to continue the questions. Okay, for example, let's see. Remember that you have to mention furniture that is not in the pictures. Okay. Está bien, pueden mencionar alguno de aquí, pero the idea is que van a mencionar 3, right, que no estaban ahí. Ok, so, let's see, Rosa Lidia Márquez, what furniture do you have, Rosa Lidia Márquez?
My living room, I have a stereo, pillow. Almohada.
One more. A stereo, pillow, and what else?
Window.
Window, okay. So, thank you, Rosa. So, what furniture do you have? So, I have an stereo, a pillow, if it is just one, right? A pillow, if it is 2 or 3 or more, pillows, okay? And a window, okay, a big window. Pueden usar más adjectives. A small window, 2 windows, 3 windows, 2 nice windows, or 2, you know, very tiny or very, very small windows. Okay, nice. So, okay. Nice. So let's see Patricia Gonzalez. Patricia Gonzalez, what furniture do you have?
I have flowers, BDB, and camera.
Okay, I have flowers, a DVD, and a camera, okay? Tratemos de usar prepositions, connectors, okay? Cada vez que mencionamos una cosa. I have a TV, and also I have a fan, and I have a lamp, and also I have two DVDs, lo que sea, right? So, nice. Let's see, Andrea Berenice. What furniture do you have in the living room?
I have a coffee maker.
No hay prega, pero como dice que ahí viene mejor.
Furthermore, a speaker and air condition.
Okay, the air condition, okay, air condition. Okay, so at the beginning you mentioned that you have what? The beginning, el primero, ¿cuál fue? Maker.
The coffee maker.
A coffee maker, so that's something that you have in the living room? Yeah? Okay, so probably, right? Probably, yes, you have a coffee maker in the living room. So you have AC, okay? Nosotros decimos aire acondicionado, right, in Spanish. So, air condition. Pero usted no necesariamente va a decir, I have air condition. So, nosotros, usted le va a decir AC. Cualquiera allá en otro país, usted le dice, I have the AC on. So, AC means aire acondicionado, right? Air condition, AC. Like, the, do you know how do you say cajero in English? ¿Cómo se dice cajero donde usted va a sacar el dinero con la tarjeta? ¿Alguien sabe?
Cash out.
ATM, I think.
Perfect, ATM. Fíjense en los cajeros, en la parte de arriba dice ATM. Nunca lo han visto. Arriba normalmente tienen un papelito, ahí dice ATM. En español, right? But in English, that's an ATM. ATM. Así se le, usted le dice a cualquiera, I need to go to the ATM. Ok. Se entiende que usted necesita ir a sacar dinero con su tarjeta. Ok. So anoten por ahí new words. Ok. ATM, el cajero. Ok. Cajero. In English, okay. Y fíjense hoy que vayan, hoy que mañana que les paguen o el día que les paguen, vaya y vea que ahí arriba dice ATM, okay. So ATM, nice, perfect. Let's see. Marlene González, what furniture do you have in the bedroom?
In the bedroom, a house bath.
A house bath. Okay. What else?
Bath.
A handbag.
Lavamano.
Ah, okay. That would be like a, like sink. Lavamanos, right? Sink. But it's correct also, the one that you have. Lo que pasa que es British and American, okay? But it's okay. What else do you have, Marlene? Just that? Something else? Okay, Marlene, creo que no le deja poner el quitar el mute, okay? No problem, no problem. So, let's see. Veamos quién más está por aquí. Bernie, what furniture do you have, Bernie?
Can you tell me where?
What furniture do you have in the living room?
Well, in my living room, I have one sofa and I have two chairs and I have my TV.
Okay, your TV is a big one or is a small TV?
It's a small TV.
Okay, I thought that you would say big one. Okay. It's a small one. Nice. Perfect. Now, Bernie, could you please ask one of the questions to one of your classmates? Choose one of your classmates and ask the question. Can be what is the furniture in the living room or in the bedroom, or you can add something else, like in the, I don't know, in the jar, like in the kitchen. Okay, so go ahead, Bernie.
Okay, let me ask you to, let me see who, to Monica. Monica, what furniture do you have in your backyard?
Monica, go ahead.
Hola, hello, repeat okay. Please.
Once again, Monica, what furniture do you have in your backyard?
In the backyard. Mm-hmm.
I have three flowers.
Okay, yes.
Yes.
Three flowers, three avocado.
Okay, avocado trees. Okay, that's avocado tree.
Avocado tree.
Okay.
Lemon tree.
Okay, perfect. Yes. Nice. Let's see. Thank you. Let's see, Rebecca Sarai. Choose one of your classmates. Rebecca Sarai, choose one of your classmates and ask one of the questions. Usted escoja a alguien de todos los que estamos aquí y hágale cualquiera de estas tres preguntas. O usted no le quiere preguntar en el living room, le quiere preguntar en el kitchen, bathroom. Okay, so go ahead, Rebecca.
Andrea.
Oh, Andrea, what, be ready.
What furniture do you have in the bedroom?
Okay, Andrea. Hello, hello. Okay, Andrea, Berenice, ahí viene. Okay, the question is, what furniture do you have in the bedroom?
In the bedroom?
Yeah.
I have, no tiene que ser repetido los que están aquí, ¿verdad?
Yeah, try to use something else, okay, besides los que pusimos ahí en la imagen.
¿Cómo se dice ventilador?
Fan.
How do you say ventilador?
Fan, that would be a fan.
Fan. I have a fan.
What else? Just that? ¿Solo eso tiene por ahí en el bedroom?
A lamp.
Okay, you have a lamp. How many lamps do you have? How many lamps do you have? Okay, cuando yo le digo how many, le estoy preguntando cuántos. Y usted me dice, mire, yo tengo una pilot. So I can ask, oh, how many pilots do you have? Okay, how many? How many es cuántos? Okay, siempre que yo le diga, how many classmates do we have? ¿Cuántos compañeros usted tiene? Okay, how many chairs do you have at home? So, ¿cuántas sillas tiene usted en la casa? So, how many? That would be cuántos, okay, that you can count. Nice. Franklin, so choose one of your classmates and ask one of the questions, please.
Okay,
What furniture do you have? So, it's for me or for another person? Hello?
Just one, Franklin. I'm sorry, I was on mute.
Okay. What furniture do you have? So,
to whom? Escoja a alguien de su clase, okay? Choose one of your classmates.
Okay, let me see. Valeria Esther.
Okay, Valeria, okay. What furniture do you have where, Osma?
I have a stool, a desk chair, nightstand.
Okay, okay. So you mentioned like a chair. How many chairs do you have?
One.
Just one?
Yes.
Okay, okay, thank you. Let's see who else. Vamos, quien no ha participado ahorita. Ludivina, Ludivina, choose one of your classmates, please, and ask one of the questions.
Dígame en español, por favor.
Okay, Ludivina, so, escoja a alguien, okay, choose one of your classmates. Usted ve ahí todos los que tienen en la camarita, ve ahí el nombre y le hace una de estas tres preguntas. Can be, what furniture do you have? What furniture do you have in the living room? Or what furniture do you have in the bedroom? O si usted le quiere preguntar de la cocina, so, what furniture do you have in the kitchen? Usted le quiere preguntar del baño, what furniture do you have in the bathroom?
No sé si ya participó Patricia González.
No, Patricia González. So be ready. Go ahead, Ludivina, with your question.
What furniture do you have in the bedroom?
Okay, in the bedroom, okay, Ludivina, bedroom, bedroom, okay, bedroom, nice. Ajá, let's see. Patricia dijo, ¿verdad?
Patricia González.
Okay, Patricia González, ajá. You are on mute. Está en silencio, Patricia. There you go.
¿Cuál es la pregunta?
What furniture do you have in the bedroom?
Okay. In the bedroom, uh-huh. I have the curtains,
uh-huh.
And picture.
Okay, curtains and pictures. Nice. Marta, Stephanie, what furniture do you have in your bedroom or in your where you are right now? What furniture, since you are at the university or where you are living over there?
Podría ser en my bedroom.
Okay, go ahead.
Bueno, in my bedroom there are 2 mirrors and 3 lamps.
Okay.
In the living room of my house, there is a television, a sofa, a picture, and curtains.
Curtains. Okay.
Curtains.
Nice. Nice. So, look, let's practice the pronunciation, okay? Estos son algunos nada más que los pusimos por acá, right? So, the parts of the house, no se le olviden las partes de la casa, por aquí les puse hasta un dibujito, okay? So, Estas partes de la casa ustedes las tienen que pronunciar bien bonito, right? So, kitchen, bathroom, dining room. Those are the ones that we have, right? Bedroom, living room, yard. So, aquí la habían más, right? But we don't have basement, but you need to know, right? So, in case if you need it. So, let's continue, okay? Because of the time, let's continue with the next activity. And we are going to work in groups, okay? So, this is the lesson 2.7. It says that at the end of this class, you will learn how to form statements with the reason that are also how to use song, no, or in any when referring to different objects, okay? Vimos esto el día de ayer, si se recuerdan, there is, it's just for one thing, and there are when we have 2, 3, 4, 5, 100,000, 10,000 objetos, right? So, cuando yo cuento algo, y usted me dice, mire, yo tengo una mesa, there is a table. Me dice, no, mire, yo tengo dos mesas, there are two tables, okay? So, let's practice, okay? So, I don't know if you can take a picture, mándenla ahí, porque cuando hago los break rooms, a veces se les elimina esto, entonces no logran mirar. So, we are going to do this one, the first and the second exercise, in small groups, okay? You have to complete the sentence with is or are, and you have to fill in the gaps, that means en los espacios, using there is or there are, o are there or is there, okay? Si fuese pregunta, vean acá, que hay algunos que son preguntas, so when it's pregunta, so we are going to put this one, are these or is there, okay? Dependiendo si es plural o singular. So, no sé si lo mandaron al grupo, in case, sí se puede ver la pantalla, aunque están en los breakout rooms, pero tienen ustedes que activar esa opción. Ahí está ya la imagen. Thank you. So, si no les da error, ¿ok? Pero sí, sí se puede. So, let me create the rooms right now. The same story, ¿ok? Cuando vaya al room, rapidito, hacer esto, tenemos 5 minutos, ¿ok? So, vamos a ver, somos ahorita 29. So, 5 grupos nada más, okay? So, 5 groups and join the group automatically, okay? De una vez se van a ir al grupo. Let's see. Here we go. Hello, Marina, are you here? Marina. Hello, Marina.
Sería is la siguiente.
¿En cuál número van?
Ah, la primera.
are.
First are. Is.
En la otra es ar, ¿verdad? Ar, ¿verdad? En la penúltima, en la J.
Sí, en la penúltima, ar.
Teacher, buenas noches.
Dice este, en la otra dice, ah, bueno, si son preguntas. In my house.
There are bedrooms in my house.
Number three.
There.
A bookcase. There is a bookcase in your room. No, it's a question. It's a question. Entonces sería.
Yeah.
Is there a bookcase in your room?
Teacher, no sé si me está escuchando.
Yes, I'm here.
Okay.
Teacher.
Yes, I'm here.
Tengo una duda. Cuando en la misma oración hay diferentes artículos, como el caso de la number four, a child, a desk, a wardrobe, en ese caso se toma como plural la oración o como singular.
Yeah, that would be plural, porque ahí es como que usted me diga, ahí está Chepe, Juan, María, José, right?
Ah, okay.
There are.
Entonces es igual como en la I de la parte de arriba,
pienso,
porque está hablando de dos cosas.
Es que tenía la duda, y también tengo duda en la, H.
Ok.
Dice ¿sí? There. Your mobile phone, ¿verdad? Pero it's cuando se refiere a your de usted, o de tú, no está también are.
Era you, no.
No, porque en this case it's just one phone, solo hay un teléfono, right? There is.
O sea que aquí es en función del artículo y no del pronombre.
Exactly, aquí, o sea, aquí va a haber los objetos, el there is and there are, ok, si es uno o son dos, right? En la otra me decía Sonia, creo que me hizo la mención ahí, right? So, ahí sería there are seven books, porque son siete libros, right?
Ahí son siete libros.
No, de la, yo le hablé de la I.
En
la I. De la I.
There a computer and a TV and my room. O sea, está hablando de dos artículos, entonces sería are.
No, there is a computer. Hay una.
No, solo ahí sería there is a computer, porque no puede ser there are a computer.
No, porque dice a computer and a TV. O sea, una computadora y un televisor.
Y un televisor. Ok, pero aquí el there is se le estaría asignando a la computer, it's just one. Siempre que vean la letra A, es uno. Cuando ustedes vean de ahí ya van dos. Okay? Ahí sería there is a computer and a TV. Okay.
Teacher, y en la G que dice there is friends, sería are o is.
¿En cuál me dijo? I'm sorry.
En la G.
The as an elephant. Let's see.
There his friends.
G, there.
No, G, letter G.
Ah, okay, letter G, there are his friends.
Sus amigos.
Sus amigos. Exactly, plural. Okay, so time is over. So we are going to go back to the main room, okay? Okay, welcome back. Welcome back. We are in the main room right now. Let's see. Yeah. Oh my God, the time is running so fast. So let's check together. Okay, be ready. Vayan, estén listos ahí porque no sé quién le va a corresponder. Let's see. Maria Veronica, number letter 8.
There are
there are
25 students in the class.
Okay, perfect. There are 25 students in the class. Nice. Luis de Jesus, letter B.
Please, excuse me, can you share the PPT?
Screen. I have the screen right now. No están viendo la pantalla.
Oh,
oh my God, ¿qué pasó? Deje ver, yo lo tengo aquí en...
No se ve.
Dios. Oops, no, este.
Ok, que tuvimos
bien. Sorry, que pensé que lo estaban viendo ustedes. Ok, nice. So, go ahead, please.
Este, teacher, la número 3 me dijo. La
letter B as in boy.
Este, fíjese que yo acabo de entrar, pero si no me equivoco, creo que es. There is a hospital in the city center.
Perfect. There is a hospital in the city center. Nice. Let's see. ¿A quién no le he preguntado? Leslie Marcela, letter C.
There is a big supermarket near my house.
Perfect. There is a big supermarket near my house. Patricia Veronica, letter D.
There are two teachers in the room.
Perfect. There are two teachers in the room. Nice. The next one, Cristia Maricela, letter E.
¿Cuál, perdón?
Letter E.
There are 12 sums on this CD.
Perfect. There are 12 sums on this CD. Rodrigo, letter F.
There is a good thing on TV tonight.
Perfect. There is a good feel on TV tonight. There is a good feel. Hay una buena película ahora en la noche en la tele, dice uno. Hoy va a salir una película buena, un feel. Ok, movie. Sí, movie es película, pero si yo le digo there is a good feel, that means movie, ok, on TV tonight. Perfect. Roberto Amilcar, letter G.
There are his friends.
There are his friends, okay? Ellos son los amigos, right? Alison Michelle, letter H.
There is your mobile phone.
Perfect. There is your mobile phone. Nice. Miguel Angel, letter I.
Letter what?
Oh,
there is a computer and a TV in my room.
Perfect. There is a computer and a TV on my room. Nice. Let's see. Next. Let's see.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
Why there is a computer and TV in my room if we're talking
about two objects? Uh-huh. We have two objects, but in this case, no suena. There are a computer and a TV in my room. Okay, there are a computer.
Yeah, because one computer and one TV,
right? Yes, that's why. Okay, one computer. Let's see, Sandra Lisette, letter J. Sandra? Hello. María de Los Ángeles?
Disculpe, Lick, no pude activar el micrófono.
Ah, okay. Go ahead. Sorry. Go ahead.
There are seven books in my bag.
Perfect. There are seven books in my bag. María de Los Ángeles, the letter K.
El mercado recto.
There is no homework today.
Perfect. There is no homework today. Yay, que chivo, no hay. So let's continue. Number one, okay. Delbert, I'll see this. Number one. Delver? Hello. ¿No está? Samuel Alejandro.
Number one.
Yes.
There is a big kitchen in my flat.
Perfect. There is a big kitchen in my flat. Marina Iglesias, number two.
There are two bedrooms in my house.
Perfect. There are two bedrooms in my house. Nice. Marlene Gonzalez, number three.
Is there a book in your room?
Perfect. Pregunta, right? Is there a bookcase in your room? Is there a bookcase in your room? Nice. Rebecca Sarai, number four.
Bookcase,
librera. Okay, librera, dijimos, right? So that's a bookcase. Okay. Number four. Go ahead, Rebecca.
Yes. There are a chair, a desk, and a wardrobe. Be the window.
Thank you. There are a chair at this wardrobe by the window. Nice. Next one will be for Jancy. Jancy Yvette Mayen, number five. Jancy? Sorry, you're on mute.
Yes. Are there three floors in your house?
Okay.
Are there three floors in your house?
Nice, perfect. Kimberly, number six.
Number six. There are living room and dining room in my flat.
Okay, there are a living room and a dining room in my flat. Nice.
Number four,
the second part is similar to the number.
The one in this one, right? Letter I. Yeah, this one will be there are. You're right. There are a computer and a TV in my living room. Okay, the same as this one. Okay, there are a living room and a dining room in my flat. Okay, There are. That's the correct one. Okay, you're right. Let's
entonces,
see.
En la parte de la, porque ya me confundí. Entonces, en la parte de la, en la primera parte, donde dice a computer, sería are.
Yeah.
Sería ahí.
Yeah, there are. Okay, there are a computer and a TV. Thank you. Okay, nice. Let's see, Valeria. Quiero ver quiénes no le he preguntado. Hoy les he preguntado casi a todos. Valeria, ajá. Valeria, number 7.
There are 5 chairs at the table.
Okay, okay. There are 5 chairs at the table. And the last one, Luis Enriquez, number 8.
Sorry, teacher, I can't see the...
Ah, no logra okay. Mirarla. Okay, go ahead.
Now, yes. There is a bookshelf on my wall.
Okay, this is a question.
No, sorry, is there?
Nice.
Is there a bookshelf?
Is there a bookshelf? Okay, bookshelf on the wall. What is bookshelf?
Teacher.
Bookshelf. I think it is a like a picture.
Like a picture?
Retrato. Un cuadro que uno pone en una foto.
Viene siendo como una nosotros decimos repisa, o sea, decimos así, right? Como una repisa, una cosita donde usted pone los libros, ok, como un estante de libros, that would be, ok, oh okay, my god, you. We have no problem, Luis, ok, yes, yeah. go ahead,
yeah,
no sé quién me está hablando, oh, María Verónica, go ahead.
Fíjese que, bueno, yo cuando estábamos en la práctica, en la parte de abajo las hice, pero no me había quedado claro. Pero ahora sí, entendí que la diferencia cuando es pregunta, solo va a ir invertido.
Exacto, solo le doy vuelta. Uh-huh. Excelente, nice. So, because of the time, yeah, Sonia, go ahead, Sonia,
bye. Diga. No me ha quedado muy claro en las preguntas, en anterior. Uh-huh. Ok, usted me dijo que there is a computer. Y en la de abajo es there are a living room, o sea.
No, and the two of them are, okay, las dos son are, okay. There are a computer and a TV, and there are a living room, dining room, y no sé qué más dice ahí, in a flat, okay. So the two of them are, okay. So that was my mistake right there. So let's continue, we have 8 minutes, okay? Esto probably va a quedar de tarea, okay? So it says right here, my dream house, okay? So I don't know if you have a dream house, okay? La casa de mis sueños, right? My dream house. It says right here, what is your dream home like? Where is it? What rooms does it have? What themes are in the room? Does it have a view? Okay, and we have some pictures right here, examples, right? This is a cabin, this is a penthouse, okay? This is la casa de sus sueños, es un penthouse. It says right here, a houseboat, una villa. So that would be like I don't know, like a huge house, right? That would be a villa. Esta es como una cabañita, right? Por ahí en un bosquecito, right? Un penthouse, that would be a very luxury flat, un apartamento bien lujoso, se llama penthouse. Okay, so in this one, the houseboat, una como casa flotante, podríamos decir, right? So those are examples, okay? So what you are going to do? Usted me va a escribir una description about your dream house. Aquí hay un ejemplo. Me look. It says, my dream home, it's a cabin in the forest. There is one large room, blah, 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 blah. So, usted me va a escribir unas que de 3 a 5 líneas. Okay. Eso va a quedar de tarea y mañana me lo van a leer. So, you have to write what is your dream house, ok, y se va a guiar con estas preguntas right here, para hacer su parrafito, ok, it says, puede empezar así, My dream house is a villa. The villa would be in a nice countryside or in a nice area, okay, near to the farm, near to the lake, donde usted quiere que esté ubicada la casa de sus sueños, right? What rooms that it had? My dream house have four rooms, un ejemplo, right? I have a bedroom, I have a dining room, I have a living room, and I have a kitchen. What themes are in the room? Oh, inside of the house, I have many furnitures, okay? Y empieza. I have three big windows in front of the house. I have a big backyard. I have many, many furnitures like tables, lamps, fans, it's a big TV, three sofas, one armchair. So empieza usted a escribir toda la furniture que usted quiere ponerle a la casa, right? And does it have a view? In my dream house, I have a beautiful view of the lake, ve el lago. No sé, usted invente. Acuérdese que es la casa de sus sueños. Usted va a inventar ahí que tiene una vista, no sé para dónde. Ok, so let's do this as a homework. Lo íbamos a hacer acá, pero por tiempo nos va a quedar de tarea. Usted escribe ahí unas 5 líneas contestando estas preguntitas sobre la casa de sus sueños. Usted invente, no necesariamente va a ser cualquiera de estos 4. Usted quiere poner otra cosa, un apartment, una huge house, una casa de playa, qué sé yo, right? So you can use your imagination. So mañana empezamos con esto. Ustedes me van a leer ese parrafito. Y si es posible, me lo pueden mandar. Bueno, mañana me lo mandan ahí al WhatsApp, ok, escrito. So let's see. Lesson 210. Lesson objective, by the end of this class, you will develop skills in scanning and reading for details. Okay, so you know what is develop skills. Esto ya lo sabe. Scanning and reading for details. Scanning, lo vimos también. Okay, cuando uno le toma un vistazo a un documento, a un artículo, a un texto, solo le echa una vista. That would be scanning, okay? No es que estoy leyendo, reading full, sino que estoy solamente así, un brochazo, rapidito. Okay, so let's see what we have. We have two special houses in the American, sorry, Southwest. Two special houses in the American Southwest. Okay, so scan the article. Where is Miss Cisneros' house? Where is Miss Nelson's house? Okay, o sea que hay dos personas aquí, Miss Cisneros and Mr. Nelson. Okay, so I'm este going to.
Una consulta, este ejercicio es el que sale en la plataforma, en la plataforma de la unidad número 2, y es el que le puse yo ahí en el WhatsApp, de que yo lo contesté. Porque ahí hay que ordenar los eventos, ¿verdad? De cada uno de ellos. Y al ordenar los eventos, cuando yo lo contesté, me sale malo. Entonces no entiendo cuál es la respuesta correcta. Porque según la lógica de la historia, así van. Y ahí me salió error. Okay. Cuando yo lo contesté y lo dejé, ya no lo, o sea, ya no seguí porque me salió error ambos párrafos.
Ok, solo que creo que el que era de ordenar no es el otro, el que hicimos la vez anterior, que había que eran tres personajes y los no, iba poniendo en orden, es de este.
Esta plata, este ejercicio es el que ponen ahí en la plataforma. Okay. Entonces, no entiendo. Yo ahí le puse en el WhatsApp al principio de que no entendía por qué sale malo, o sea, si al verle la lógica a los eventos, hay que ordenar cuál es primero, segundo, tercero. Entonces, al ordenarlo, me sale malo. Entonces, como solo se puede una vez arreglar, yo la primera vez me salió malo, ya lo dejé así. Entonces, para terminar la plata, la unidad 2, yo lo he dejado esa parte sin llenar.
Ok, lo voy a...
Ahí hay que escoger de qué casa se está hablando. Y nada más señalar de que si es la señora Cisneros, si es,
o solo es Mr. Nelson.
Sí, no, claro, sí, yo lo leí todo y como ahí lo lee uno todo primero y de ahí se va ordenando. Entonces son tres preguntas nada más.
Voy a revisar, es el ejercicio, la parte del 2.12. I will check. Okay.
Para no perder los puntos, lo dejé así.
Teacher, yo sí lo resolví, pero es arriba, abajo de la lectura aparecen las palabras con las que uno va a completar.
Exacto, así es.
Voy a revisar, ok, voy a revisar y le aviso.
Teacher, sorry, ¿será que me puedo retirar ahorita? Lo que pasa es que estamos teniendo problemas con el agua, entonces le voy a ayudar a mi abuelo.
Ok, who are you? Para poner la asistencia.
Leslie Marcela López.
Ok, go ahead, Leslie. So thank I have you. To pass the attendance. Alison Michelle. Alison, present. Thank you. Andrea Berenice.
Present.
Delbert Alcides.
Present, teacher.
Andrea. Yeah, thank you. Delbert, por ahí lo vi, pero no sé si tiene problemas con el audio. Franklin.
Present, teacher.
Kimberly. Crisia.
Present, miss.
Leslie, Lourdes Michelle. Lourdes Michelle. Ludivina.
Present.
Luis de Jesús.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Luis. Luis Fernando.
Present, teacher.
María de Los Ángeles. María Verónica.
Present, María de Los Ángeles.
Marina Celeste.
Present, teacher.
Okay, okay. Celeste. Marlene y Dinora, ahí está. Celeste, me confirma que present. Esté. Thank you, Marlene. Sé que ahí está. Marta Stephanie.
Present, teacher.
Marta Stephanie.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Miguel Ángel.
Present.
Thank you, Mónica. Norman, Bernie, present. Ahí está. Patricia Elizabeth.
María de los Ángeles, present.
Thank you. Sí, ahí le puse ya. Patricia, thank you. Patricia Verónica.
Present.
Thank you. Rebeca Saraí.
Present.
Thank you. Roberto Amilcar.
Present.
Thank you. Rodrigo.
Present, teacher.
Rosalidia.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Samuel.
Present.
Thank you. Sandra Lisette.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Sonia.
Present.
Valeria and Jansen.
Present.
Okay, thank present. You. Okay, ahí. Puso... Sí, todos prácticamente están presentes, menos Lourdes, no me aparece. Then all of you are here. Okay, so thank you. See you tomorrow. Okay, no olviden hacer la tarea y si ya lo hacen ahora, me lo pueden enviar ahí el grupo, el textito que van a hacer de su dream house. Okay, so see you tomorrow. Okay, thank you for being on time and thank you for being in the class. So hope to see you tomorrow. Nice.
Good night.